All right, so now we're done completely, done with the running the vinegar through the system, which is descaling it. So now we're going to turn it off and hook everything back up and restart this the system. Run some water through it, yeah.
That's the way you can rinse it, you know.
Uh-huh. So, you keep this thing hooked up?
Yeah, you can just get the pump out of there, and I can just get rid of the thing and turn it off to mine.
Okay. Let's do that then.
You can just leave it like that right now. Just dump it in there. Yeah, it has some greenish color, so yeah, definitely want some calcium on it.
Yeah, but so if we want to ride through, it's going to go through this here.
Yeah, so we have to empty the bucket and then fill them up with some water. Put this back on?
Yeah.
You have the key in there?
No, I just hand tightened it.
Oh, okay.
This should be enough.
Yep.
Yep. All right. Open up that again. It's one of the best things that Orlando gave me was that submersible pump.
Oh, you got it from him?
Yeah. That thing works for my pool, too. For the drain my pool? Yeah.
Mm-hmm. How long did it drain? A few days?
No, I took
eight hours. Wow.
Yeah, about 8 hours. I had to move a few times, you know. It would get dry, mm-hmm. the spot, the shallow end. But I think it took like a little over 8 hours.
Wow. Did you dump the water through the end?
Yeah. I did.
Pretty expensive to get them out, huh?
Nope, because I took the heater off. And I
called my husband.
The first time I did it, I cost about $300 a while ago. And for this time, I went the last two times. I had to do it like three times total. That time I did it.
Wow.
I said, you do it at night. Put it in there and I would get up there early in the morning and I would put the thing back in.
I guess that's the only reason the only meters they hot outside is the water.
Yeah.
For some reason.
Mm-hmm.
That should be enough there.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's just to get rid of the any area inside.
Yeah.
So you can just disconnect the lines and then I'll take everything there. Okay. And start working on the other one and then you put everything together.
Alright. So now that water's back on, getting ready to sew through, and then we can plug this back in here. igniting, kicking on. And we can turn this on here. Get the water on. Oops. There's one thing we forgot to do. You gotta turn this off. Yeah. The opposition. Let me put this thing right back on. We gotta put the filter back on there. So all we wanna do is we wanna take this off. Red bucket. Okay, now that we got that on, you see the temperature is 120, which is the factory recommended temperature. And then I'm going to go turn on a faucet here, hot side, and you should see that thing start kicking in. Check down here, make sure there's no leaks of any kind. Check down here and make sure we have all the piping with no leaks, which we do not have any leaks. You can see that water going through that filter, as it's supposed to be doing. So all the valves in the open position, all the plugs are plugged. Use. You can see the The new sign is on right here. It's 120 degree temperature. And then
over here at this side, you can feel a little hot water coming out. It's very hot.
So now we are completed here with the system here. We have the system restored back on.
We got hot water coming through already. So we just turn this off. And then once we turn this off,
that comes off. And then you can see the system is no longer in use. So that means now this is not working, it shuts off. And now you're not using gas and you're not using hot water. So the system is off and therefore no hot water is going through the system and you're not losing gas usage because it's completely shut itself down. So that completes this Rinnai tankless water heater descaling and flushing system. And I hope you enjoyed this video. And as we've walked you through the step-by-step, I do also have a chart here, paper here, of showing how this process works. And it's a step-by-step paper that I do that sometimes the customers may want to do it themselves, and I give them the helpful information. So now we're going to go to the other side of the house and then go to the other water heater and see how that one's doing.
Get the screen on, right?
Yeah, I put the screen on. Okay. So I almost forgot the screen, but okay. I put it on. So,
all right, got the other ones going on already.
So. Okay, so that one's started. All right, so we can take this. Yeah, this container. Yeah. Here, go ahead.
We need the light down, so.
No. This is a good idea. Okay, so here we are on the other side of the house now, and this is the Noritz EZ-TR40 that we have. We're descaling and flushing out as well. This is a different brand of tankless water heater system. They do the identical thing. They work when they're in use, and they don't work when they're not in use. It provides endless hot water so that they can be running two fixtures going on at the same time without anybody's being short of hot water. And attachments on this unit are opposite. As you can see, everything is on the top, whereas the other unit, everything was on the bottom, which was convenient for the idea of the installation and how they wanted to make that cabinetry there and the countertop, that everything being on the bottom was much more workable for that unit. So depending on which you want to put this unit at, it would depend on which type of brand you'd want to go with, if you want to go with the top mounted or the bottom mounted. And then you can see this one here has got the pump there, the condensate pump, to allow the water to discharge through when it condensates. Then we have the TMP valve here dropping into a drip pan because we don't have an outside variance, so it can go through the wall and into a piping. You'd have to go straight terminate to the ground, and therefore we have to have a drip pan to be able to catch any flow of water that may come out if it blows off
any pressure. Then you can see the valves here are a little bit different, a little bit more easier to handle. So you got the hot and the cold on there, and then this is where the plug is at, where the filter goes. And then here we got the sediment trap filter here above, and then there's a main in the shutoff. The good thing about these Norris Easy systems is that you can actually use the existing B vent. So this vent here, even though it looks like it's a dryer vent, is actually a sleeve for the actual PVC pipe that's going through and up into the terminating to the top of the roof there, to the rooftop with a hood to keep water from going in there. And it's got the seal, so you can adapt it to 3-inch or 4-inch, however you want to, however size piping you have, it'll fit to it. And like I said, this actually is code, because this is actually not the, this never gets hot, and it never has melting problems. But there is actually a PVC pipe or plastic piping inside here that's connected to the B vent that's allowing the airflow, the air to flow through for the combustible gas. So tested the other system working right away, and it ran just perfect. No delay or anything.
They have this one without the condensate line, right?
No, these all have the condensate line, unless it's an electric one.
Oh.
But the gas ones all have all the condensate. And then the outside ones, the external one, it does not have condensate.
It can be installed in the inside, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
As a matter of fact, at our customer, we installed the Uniford not too long ago, realtor that was remodeling our house, and we ran new gas inside the for the stove range.
Mm-hmm.
She said that she smells gas somewhere near the stove, you know what I mean? Or like, so I was going to have to go over there to spray it and check and see if we see this, if there's anything leaking. Not from the piping that we put in, but from where they hooked up the
might be the range.
Might be
those.
I can do this or that. We got this covered. Thank you.
cleaner than the other one.
Those are yours, right?
Yes.
Get the filter in there?
Yeah, I got the filter.
Oh, okay. That's why I'm gonna shut that off. That's gonna be tied up more.
Missing the O-ring.
What's the O-ring?
There. That's what I have.
look into finding another one of those pumps, submersible pumps.
It's got a lot of pressure though.
Yeah, I think it has some air, because you can hear the air inside the lamp. That's what it is.
Oh, maybe also because it's going through that too, right? Yeah.
So the filter probably will loosen it first. It should be enough.
The leaking?
Yeah. You have to put the channel locks on it?
That's where the O-ring goes, right?
Let's see. No, I don't think so. Side of it like that. Yeah, I have to go here because that's the hottest part.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure he was there.
Yeah. I don't imagine it going around that part. Because that part actually never threads into there, right?
No, it does. Yeah, it has to go there. It has to be there. Oh, but if you go too tight, see?
I'll just squeeze it.
So it's not a nice button.
Mm-mm. So this must,
the skinny part.
Yeah.
Let's try it.
Yeah, it goes there. Okay, that's on, that's off, off.
Okay, so, get the gas. So let's start it up. You got the one. You got the indication there on that on there. Yep, 120. And it shows. So the system is in kicked on. So it's ready to be put in use. And he's going to turn on the hot water. And you can hear it starting to operate. You hear it kicking in. Yep. There's those breathable vents. Everything is a go. Water's running through. No leaks. So what?
Oxidation in the water.
So what?
Oxidation was brown.
Oh.
They probably won't use this one too much. Probably don't use it that much, huh?
All right, so then you got the hot water running. Okay, good pressure there.
It's already hot.
And it's already getting hot. So these faucets now are good, good water, hot water, and back in service. So that completes our descaling and flushing of the tankless water system units that we just did. This is the Noritz here, and we did the Renai on the other side of the house. And that's the process. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you have any comments or questions, definitely give those a question asked, and I would definitely like to answer those questions. And also, if you like this video, please hit that like button, and if you do, hit that bell to subscribe. And also give me some good feedback about this video. Thank you very much, and you have a good, happy Friday, and happy pre Mother's Day for all you mothers. Thank you very much.